Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to the video, coming to you live. Well, not live. You guys are watching this like a day or two after, but coming to you guys from beautiful Florida. Obviously not in my normal living space here in a hotel right now, and actually not so beautiful Florida because it has been raining all morning since I got here, but still it is way warmer. It's currently 69 degrees, so I can definitely deal with that compared to the 30 degrees back in Indiana. But gonna be spending the next couple weeks here on kind of vacation, just kind of hanging out in my favorite place. It's actually where I used to live. I'm actually in Sarasota right now. Gonna be going to Orlando, gonna be going to Disney in a couple days with my family, then going to be going to Fort Myers for about a week and a half, just kind of exploring and having fun down there, and then probably come back to Sarasota for a couple days. So over the next couple weeks, going to be vlogging a lot more. I know I've been slacking big time on the videos, but while I'm down here in Florida, I can really just kind of soak it all up, have a lot of fun, and kind of take you guys along with me. But because I flew down and I did not bring any luggage with me, all I brought was my gym bag and some, like, an extra pair of clothes, because my family is coming down in 2 days, and, well, actually it's about a day and a half now. They're coming down in a day and a half, and I just decided, rather than paying for an extra bag of luggage, since they're driving down, I just pack my suitcase for the 2 weeks and then let them bring it down. So I really don't have too much. Like, right there, those are all the clothes I have for 2 days. Wasn't able to bring pre-workout, wasn't able to bring protein or anything like that, so all my supplements are coming down in a couple days. But because of that, I don't really have a pre-workout right now, and I'm about to head to the gym, Around the Clock Fitness, which is my favorite gym. You guys saw me working out there if you guys have been following me for a while. Last year was my favorite gym. I went there every single day when I lived down here in Florida. Absolutely love that gym, and I'm heading there right now, but I don't have a pre-workout, so I'm going to head to the gas station, pick up a Monster or something, and then head to the gym, and I'll see you guys there. Guys, so just got here to the gym. Been sipping on my Monster for the past 20, I don't know, it took me about 20 minutes to get here from my hotel. So going to finish this off real quick and then head into the gym. Going to be doing chest and triceps today. Not really sure how full it is right now inside there. The parking lot's pretty full, but it is kind of Christmas break, so a bunch of the students are probably home. A bunch of people are, like, when it's Florida, when it's Christmas time in Florida, everything is packed because this is a huge tourist location, obviously. So pretty much any time of the day is going to be full at the gym. You can't really find hit or miss times like when I lived down here and I was able to go in like the summer and the fall and things like that. So I'm going to head in here, going to record as much of this chest and tricep workout as I can for you guys. So here we go.
Time to raise up and petition.
All my life been sitting at the table, watching them kids and living in a fable. Looks like money and never left the wishing. Now it's about time to stand up and petition.
Cause I've been wondering when you're gonna see I'm not for sale. I've been questioning when you're gonna see I'm not a part of your life.
Paint this town with my very own vision.
I'm not scared of what you're gonna tell me. I'm not scared of the beast in the belly. Fill my cup with endless ambition and paint this town with my very own vision.
Cause I've been wondering when you're gonna see I'm not for sale. I've been questioning when you're gonna see I'm not a part of your life.
Yeah.
guys, so just got done with my workout, and I know it is still raining a little bit, so got a little wet on my way out, but for the most part, I was sweating like crazy during that workout, and I'm gonna be honest, it feels so good to really sweat again during a workout. Whenever I worked at Lakeside, my old gym, the one that closed down, I could never, ever get a sweat going just because that place was so incredibly cold. Then when I came down here to Florida, perfect, I loved it. I could always sweat here at around the clock. And then my new gym, Eastlake or Aries, it's owned by Eastlake, but it is Aries. Sometimes I can break a sweat there. It's kind of hit or miss how much the front door is opening, because obviously it's Indiana and it's cold outside, but the door stays closed. Obviously you can break a pretty good sweat there, but nothing like getting workouts in here down in Florida. Absolutely love it. Great chest workout, great tricep workout. Didn't record every exercise, but I got a few of them. But now about to go get some food, some post-workout food, and I know exactly where I'm going. I'll show you guys. All right, thank you. All right, guys, so picked up my post-workout meal, got myself some Chick-fil-A, which I have been missing dearly. There's just no Chick-fil-A anywhere close to where I live. I either have to drive an hour to Mishawaka at the mall, or I have to drive an hour to Fort Wayne, and it's just really frustrating. I don't have one of my favorite, I mean, obviously, Moe's is my favorite, but other than that, like, Chick-fil-A is a very, very close number two. So got myself a Chick-fil-A sandwich, got myself a thing of fries, and then I also got myself an 8-count nugget, going ham on these. Oh, I spilled my fries, and there's people just pulled in straight across from me in the parking lot, and they're hardcore staring at me talking to my camera right now. So I'm just gonna eat my food and watch a YouTube video and stop being so awkward. So yeah. So home, showered, getting ready to head to the movies right now. Stopped at Walmart on my way back to pick up a few things of candy. By the way, I always put my candy in the fridge because, I don't know, that's just one thing I've always done. I like my candy cold. But I picked up a little bit of Sour Patch Kids, the watermelon, and then these like sour Mike and Ikes. I don't know why they don't just call them sours, but they are sour Mike and Ikes. I'm going to take these to the movies with me because I'm not about to pay $6 for a bag of sour Skittles. So I'm going to the movies now to see Bumblebee, and I'll let you guys know what I think afterwards. All right, guys. So just got done from seeing a Bumblebee. Let me turn this on real quick. Just got done from seeing a Bumblebee, and gonna keep this short and sweet because I know there's a lot in this vlog, plus I'm going to be seeing Aquaman tomorrow and reviewing that at the end of the video. So what I thought about Bumblebee, I couldn't have been more impressed with this movie. Seriously, I went into this movie, I mean, the trailers have made this look pretty good, but all the trailers for all the Transformers movies have always been super good. You've always been super pumped, no matter how bad the previous Transformers movie was, to see the next one. And I think after that fifth Transformers movie, the last night, I was done. I was done with Transformers movies. When they said they were making a Bumblebee, not interested, no thank you. So even though these trailers looked good, my expectations were very, very low. And even if my expectations would have been as high as the previous Transformers movies, I think this would have exceeded them. This wasn't just the best Transformers movie. This was by far the best Transformers movie. This had what no other Transformers movie has even attempted to have. It had heart. You felt for the characters in this movie. You felt connected to more than just the Transformers. In the other Transformers movies, sure, you feel connected to the Transformers, I guess, but you've never once felt connected or at all have any emotional investment in the actual human characters. And this movie, this movie had it. This movie seriously had it. Hailee Steinfeld as the lead, you seriously felt for her throughout this entire movie. You felt connected to her and her relationship with Bumblebee, and you felt for Bumblebee. The Transformers Bumblebee emoted so much, evoked so much emotion in this movie, and had so much heart. And that's what every other Transformers movie has lacked. It's had amazing action. The visual effects have always been great. The plot's always been pretty wonky. I mean, pretty simple for the most part. But it's always lacked heart. It's always lacked those characters you can attach yourself to and really fall in love with. And this movie had that. That's all the Transformers movies have really been missing, is heart in its characters. And they finally had it. And this movie was seriously so good. I had so much fun with it. The scenes, we've seen the trailers, they show some scenes from Cybertron. Those were straight from the old cartoon. Seriously, those looked so good. The Transformers actually looked a little bit different in this movie. They harkened back to some of those animated characters that we kind of grew up with and that we kind of grew accustomed to. They harkened back to that a little bit more, and I really, really liked that. But overall, this movie was awesome. Seriously. Absolutely loved it. If I was to rank it, I'd probably give it like an 8.5 out of 10, which, again, by far the best Transformers movie. Absolutely loved it. But about to head back to my hotel now, get some sleep, wake up tomorrow, and get that day started. So, see you guys in the morning.
The next day.
Good morning, guys. Just stopped here at Wawa. I don't know if you guys can see that back there, but just stopped at Wawa for a little pre-workout meal. Obviously going to have a Monster, but then going to also have one nice, delicious glazed donut right there to get some carbs, some fat, and some energy for this back workout, which I am headed to right now. It's still pretty early in the morning. Checked out of my hotel, stopped here, gonna eat this, probably watch like a YouTube video or something, just kind of like sit, get in the right mindset, let this settle, and then go hit a back workout. So gonna eat this, and I'll see you guys in the gym. So just got out from seeing Aquaman, and I know you were probably able to tell from the trailers, but this movie was very over the top. It was very visual effects heavy. It was ridiculous, but it was awesome. Just how maybe like BVS or Justice League was ridiculous and over the top at times, those movies never really had that awesome and fun factor. This movie was at times very cheesy, but it never lost its sense of fun. This movie was an adventure. Seriously, it was an adventure from start to finish, and it was so much fun. Was it the tightest, best movie ever? No, it wasn't. I didn't even like it as much as Bumblebee last night. But on pure enjoyment, this movie was fun to watch. Sure, I think the runtime was right under 2.5 hours, so it was long, and at times it felt long. But I had so much fun with it. And Jason Momoa as Aquaman, props to you, man. Aquaman is now cool because Jason Momoa is as badass and awesome as any dude can be. Jason Momoa, seriously, Aquaman's awesome. Like, I would have never said that 5 years ago. I would have never said Aquaman's awesome. But Jason Momoa has seriously made Aquaman so cool, and I love that character. I'm excited to see kind of what they do with him in the future. But yeah, I really did enjoy this movie. And the visual effects. I know I said it at the beginning that this movie was visual effects heavy. Oh my goodness, was this movie visual effects heavy. Everything under the sea, I don't know how they did it. I don't. Like, when I buy this Blu-ray, I will watch the special features and the behind the scenes and the making of this movie, because I am just so interested how they did everything under the sea. Because it looked breathtaking. Like, the movie couldn't have looked better for how it had to take place under the sea. And oh my goodness, the final battle. We saw a glimpse of it in the trailer. The final battle under the sea is maybe the coolest thing I have seen in theaters in 2018. It's right up there with some of the stuff from Avengers Infinity War or some of the big movies like in Black Panther or other superhero movies that I've seen this year. But oh my goodness, that final battle in Aquaman was awesome. Seriously. Saw two good movies in 2 days. Bumblebee was awesome. Aquaman was awesome and fun. If I was to rate, I think I gave Bumblebee yesterday an 8.5. If I was to rank Aquaman, it would probably be right around a 7. Just at times it might have been a little too cheesy. Some of the jokes didn't quite hit. Kind of a bit too over the top, and at times maybe not consistent with what they set up Aquaman to be. Like, sometimes in Justice League, Aquaman would just fly. I don't know why Aquaman was flying in Justice League, but he didn't in this movie. So at times you are kind of like, wait, why isn't he doing this, or why is that happening, or whatever. But still, a super, super fun movie. Definitely recommend going to see it. These two movies, definitely over the holidays, go see these two movies. Very, very fun times at the theaters. But this is going to wrap up the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. The next one coming to you guys is the Disney vlog. So make sure to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. If you haven't subscribed, go hit that red subscribe button, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Peace.